So students, let's move towards the functions of the skeletal system. Earlier we had already known about the skeletal system is the framework of bones. Okay, then what will be the functions of the skeletal system? Here it gives shape, strength and support to the body. Okay, it gives shape due to the bone, framework of bone. That's why it gives shape to our body or any organisms. Okay, now the next one, it helps to move our body with the help of muscles. Okay, so what will be the function of the skeletal system? It gives strength, shape, support to the body as well as movement of our body. Okay, it protect the delicate internal organ. Delicate internal organ, as you know, that heart, lungs, spinal cord, brain, these all are the soft organ which protected by the skeleton. Okay, now the next one is your bones help in the production of RBCs. RBCs, it means a red blood cells. Got it? There are many more functions of it. Like you can say that endocrine regulations, storage, protection, movement and blood productions also. These are the functions of skeletal system. Okay? Get it? So you have to remember these four points. It will come definitely in your exam. What will be the function of skeletal system? You need to remember this. Protection, help in protection, helps in movement, it gives shape, support and strength to the body, and in the formation of RBC, red blood cells. Got it? So next point we will discuss about the joints. So students, let's talk about the joints. Okay, how many joints are present in skeletal system? So overall in the body there are many types of joints. Okay, later we will discuss about that. Joints, what do you mean by joints? The place where the two bones meet is called a joint. It means that there is two types of bones where the meet, that point is known as joints. This is your joints. Okay, so the place where the two bones meet is called a joint. The bones are joined together by strong tissue. There is present of a strong tissue that is known as the ligaments. The bones are joined together by strong tissue called ligaments. You have to remember this point. Okay, what do you mean by the ligament? Ligament is the name of a strong tissue which helps to join the two bones between each other. Okay, now joints may be movable joints or immovable joints. Movable joints, it means which allow to movement in any direction or in one direction, whatever, but it can easily move. But immovable joints, if we are talking about immovable joints, it means that don't allow any types of movement. Okay, later we will discuss about the immovable joints. Firstly we would like to discuss about movable joints. There are how many types of joints are present which is known as movable joints. Later we will discuss. Okay, so joints can be movable, it may be immovable joints. Firstly I would like to discuss about the movable joint. Movable joint, it means it can move freely. Okay, what are the name of joints which is found in movable? The first one is your ball and socket joint. Ball and socket, it means there is a two bones, one bone is fit into the another one bone. Okay, the second one, hinge joint, pivot joint. The fourth one is your gliding joint. Okay, the first one, look here, ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joint, it means it allows movements in all the directions. Okay, this type of joint is found in the hips portions or in shoulder portion. Okay, means you can easily move your hand in all the direction like this. Okay, in all the direction it can freely move. That's why it is known as ball and socket joints. Okay, you need to remember that where is the movement, what happened in the this type of joints. So ball and socket joint, it means it allow all the direction movement. You remember it, it allows movement in all the direction. Where it is formed? Hips and shoulders. Okay, the first bone is fit into the socket like structure, and you can say that into the another bone, into the another hole of the bones that is fitted. Okay, that's why it is known as ball and socket joint. So next we will discuss about the hinge joint. So the next topic is your hinge joints. Okay, we will discuss about the hinge joints. They allow movement the bones upward or downward direction. Okay, hinge joint. Earlier we had discussed about the ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joint allow movement in all the direction. Hinge joint, it allow movement in one direction, or you can say upward or downward. Okay, downward direction it can helps to move. Okay, now where we can find hinge joint? Elbows, fingers, knees and toes. Or you can say that students, it's your leg. Okay, so as you know, leg we can move in downward, only the downward direction. Here is your bone. So this is your joint, knee joint. Okay, knees. So here is present your hinge joints. Okay, now you can see that in your hand like this. This is your elbow. Elbow is having hinge joint. Okay, it allow only the upward direction. So it can allow only one direction, or downward or upward. Which type of joint is present in knee and elbow? You need to remember, hinge joint is present in knee, elbow, finger. Finger also we can move in upward direction only, okay? We can't able to move like this, okay? So elbow, finger, knees and toes, which type of joint is present? Hinge joint. Because it allows movement of the bones upward or downward direction, okay? The next topic we'll discuss about the pivot joint. So the third one is your pivot joint. Okay, this joint help us to move our head upward, downwards and sideways movement. As you know student, this is present, this type of joint is present in our neck. Okay, so whenever you are going to move your head, you can easily move your head in upward direction. Upward direction, this is your spinal cord. Okay, neck portions, this is your spinal cord, this is your head. Okay, so if you are going to talk about your head movement, we can move our head upward direction, downward direction as well as sideways direction. Get it, my points? So movement, pivot joints allow the movement of our head upward, downwards and sideways movement. Okay, where is found pivot joint? It is found in our neck portion. Okay, the next topic we will discuss, gliding joints. So the next topic is your gliding joints. Okay, it is the last one of your movable joint. Gliding joints, what will happen in this? Look here, it allows the bones to slide against each other and back to bend, twist and turn at each joints. Okay, for example, where is found gliding joint? Gliding joint is found in our wrist portion like this. Okay, and ankle, between any two vertebrae. Earlier we had discussed about the vertebral column. There is 33 numbers of bones are present in vertebral column. So every two vertebrae of the backbone, this type of joint is present. Okay, I hope this is you well understand about the types of joints. So in the next video we will learn something more. Okay, thank you.